Hello, and welcome to WingCast, a podcast about all things Goldwing. I'm your host, Rick Arnoldo, president of WingStuff.com and lifelong rider of the Honda Goldwing. In this podcast, we talk about the latest Goldwing news, speak with fellow riders and experts in the motorcycle industry, and discuss whatever else comes to mind. We'd love to have you join us.
We have a very special guest and friend of mine returning to the show this morning, and that is Fred Rau. He was the senior editor of Motorcycle Consumer News for many years, as well as Road Rider Magazine, Wing World Magazine. He was very involved with Pediatric Brain Tumor Foundation. He's won the AMA MVP Award for the most valued person in motorcycling. And Fred actually started National Ride to Work Day, which is on June 20th. And Fred is also Master of Ceremonies each year at Americade, at the big rally, which is going on right now. And that's where Fred is. So we're going to let Fred talk. Fred, how was Americade, live at Americade? Fred Rau.
Oh, I got to tell you, it is so great to be back. I mean, this is my 30th year at Americade, and now obviously because they had to move the dates and it got canceled last year and the pandemic and all that crap going on, it's not the size that it would normally be. I mean, in the old days we'd see 30,000-35,000 motorcycles here, but still I don't know the count, but by my guess I would say there are 10,000, maybe 12,000 motorcyclists here, which is still a pretty darn good turnout, you know. And the thing is the attitude, because everybody's got the cabin fever. They haven't been riding for a year and a half. They haven't been to rallies, and they're all just so excited to be here, you know, that they're the enthusiasm level is just through the roof. It really is. So it's fun. We're having a lot of fun. We really
That's awesome. That's so awesome. Yeah, Americade, and you know, up in Lake George, New York, talk about beautiful. It's so nice up there.
This is one of the prettiest places on earth. It absolutely is.
Wow. So how was the ride out there, Fred?
Oh, well, you know, to tell you the truth, we didn't have a lot of time. So it was just kind of a straight shot on the interstate to get here as quick as we could. So I really can't say anything about that. But we have allotted ourselves a couple of weeks, a little more than a couple of weeks to get home. So when Americade is over on Sunday, then we plan on having some fun, visiting some old friends in Rhode Island and Connecticut and New Jersey, you know, and stopping off in Denver, where Sherry's from, and stopping off in Kansas City, where I'm from, you know, seeing family and friends all along the way. So that part we're really excited about, you know, but just being right here, seeing a lot of folks we haven't seen in several years, is a big thrill. We had breakfast with a bunch of them this morning. We had dinner with a bunch of them last night.
That's great.
Alonzo Bowden is here. For those of you who don't know, he's a fairly famous comedian, winner of Last Comic Standing on TV and a headliner at places like the MGM Grand and Caesar's Palace in Las Vegas, and an avid motorcyclist. He was here last night, put on a show, just tore the house down. I mean, we were all in stitches, falling out of our chairs. So it's exciting. It's fun. I'm so happy to be back. You know,
that's so great. And I know it got canceled last year, and you were real bummed out about that. A lot of people were.
Yeah,
I know.
A lot of people were.
Wow. Well, you get to take some side roads going home and, you know, enjoy yourself a little bit more. You said you're going to stop and see friends in Rhode Island. I thought I was the only friend in Rhode Island that you
were. Rhode Island, geez. Got some very good friends in Rhode Island.
There you go.
You know what? I like to go to Rhode Island, and I wish to hell I could remember the name of this place. I know how to find it, but I don't remember the name of it. There's this incredible lobster place that only has outdoor seating. Oh my God, I wish I could remember the name of it. I got to get by there, man. They make lobster rolls to die for.
I think I know where you're talking about. Is that in Newport, Rhode Island? Jamestown?
It's near Newport. I know that. Yeah.
I've been there, and I know the place you're talking about. It's fantastic. It has picnic tables forever. Outside. I've
been there since the 40s, I think.
Yeah. Oh, we have some great lobster and seafood in Rhode Island where I grew up. I have to tell you that.
Oh, yeah. Absolutely. Yeah. People talk about Maine. They don't understand. I think it's better in Rhode Island.
Oh, yeah. No, I'll tell you what. I'm pretty spoiled when it comes to seafood because I grew up in Rhode Island, and we have incredible seafood. Yeah,
well, but yeah. I think I blew your socks off in New Zealand.
Okay.
Mussels.
I'll admit that. I'll admit that because, you know, folks.
You were walking 6 feet off the ground, buddy.
Yeah. I always told Fred for years that green lip mussels from New Zealand were one of my favorite seafoods. And he had been trying to get me on this New Zealand tour, this motorcycle tour that he organizes, which we'll get into towards the end of the podcast. And I finally went with him. And boy, I'll tell you, I'd go to New Zealand just for the food. Oh, yeah. Boy, was that food good.
You would.
Wow.
Yeah.
I'll tell you that. So one thing I wanted to mention to you and your wife, Sherry, is happy anniversary, by the way. It's your 50th anniversary.
Yes. It was our 50th anniversary in February. We were kind of bummed out. Of course, the pandemic, we pretty much just sat home alone for our 50th. But when we got here, our lovely, incredible, amazing Americade family held a surprise party for us last night with this gigantic cake with our faces on it. It was, so we did our 50th anniversary party last night with about 600 of our closest friends.
That is so awesome. I know I saw some of the pictures on social media. That's why I wanted to mention that this morning. So anyway, Fred, and Fred's anniversary is in February. So, you know, this is a big deal for him and Sherry to ride out there to Americade. When's the last time Sherry went with you to Americade on a bike? It's been a few years.
She hasn't been here for 4 years. Okay. So it's a big thrill for her. It really is.
Yeah.
She's been to, I think, 12 Americades, maybe more, maybe as many as 15. I'm not sure.
Yeah.
Yeah, she hasn't been here for 4 years, so she's really, really excited at bouncing all over the place, hugging people, you know.
That's awesome. So tell people a little bit about Americade, because as I said before, folks, Fred has been the master of ceremonies at Americade for 30 years now. This is his 30th anniversary doing that. And Americade is something that a lot of people that I know attend, no matter where they live, because it's such a beautiful place. And the nice thing about Americade, Fred, is it's a mix of motorcycles, isn't it? It's not just about one bike.
No, it's not. Now, it is touted as a touring rally, and it is primarily touring riders. But they come on all types of bikes, you know.
Sure.
There's nothing here that's really dominant. You see, this is one of the few places where you see the Goldwings and the Harleys and the BMWs and the Ducatis all together, you know, one group with one thing in common that they just love to ride, you know.
Yeah.
And it's a very family-oriented rally, which is one of the things we love about it. You're not going to find wet T-shirt contests here or burnout contests or stuff like that. This is a much more sedate, you know. It's about the camaraderie and the riding up in the Adirondacks and the food and the comedy shows and the boat tours and rodeos and all kinds of stuff. It's just a carnival for motorcycling.
So, Fred, each year, when is Americade held? Because some of the people out there know about it.
Always been held the first 4 week in June. Until now, This is the first one. It was moved to September again because of the pandemic. And of course, that accounts a lot for the reduced attendance, you know.
Sure.
That and the fact that the Canadians can't get in. Because you understand Lake George is only like an hour and a half from the Canadian border.
Oh, sure.
You know, they can't get in. So we're probably missing 5,000-6,000 Canadians that would normally be down here. But Bill Dutcher, who owns it, Christian Dutcher, who runs it, have told me that next year we're back to our regular venue, first full week in June.
Yeah. And you know, I didn't think of that because the Canadians come down for this event and there's thousands of them that come down.
Big time.
Big time.
When the weekend rolls around, the Canadians just pour over the border, particularly for the expo, the trade show.
Sure.
Probably the main thing they like to do is the tires cost a lot less here. Or less taxes on them and stuff. So the tire manufacturers set up here, and the Canadians will all put off until the first week in June so that they can ride over the border, get their tires changed, and ride back. And that way they don't have to pay all the Canadian taxes
on them. Oh, yeah. This has been going on for years.
Yeah, I know. For a long time.
We'd have this massive amount of motorcyclists coming in from Canada because of what Fred just said. They'd get tires installed and, you know, they'd have vendors there with accessories and stuff. And also the beauty of Lake George. I mean, Lake George is so beautiful.
Yeah. You know, we're right on the very lip of the Adirondack State Park. And a lot of people don't realize it, but and this is a weird statistic, but the Adirondack State Park has more riding roads in it, more miles of riding roads than any six national parks combined.
I did not know that.
Yes, there are hundreds of miles of beautiful, twisty mountain roads in the Adirondacks. It's I've never found anything to top it short of maybe New Zealand or the Alps, you know?
I didn't realize that.
Oh, yeah. Wow.
Beautiful. Wow. Yeah, there's some beautiful motorcycle roads in this country, and people just need to discover them. Tail of the Dragon back east. I mean, a little different.
I like to do that. I find it just kind of tiring.
Right.
What is it? Like 411 curves and 11 miles or something?
Yes. You know? Yes.
Yeah. And of course, that's very, very popular, and they get big crowds there, and they have lots of accidents there.
Yes, they do.
Quite frankly, not more than like 30 miles from there, there's kind of a secret place called Wolf Pen Gap. And to me, it's actually a better riding road, and almost nobody knows about it. So you go to Wolf Pen Gap and ride that instead.
All right. The secret's out, folks.
Yeah. I shouldn't give away my secrets. Yeah.
only on WingCast, you know,
yeah.
Only on WingCast. Anyway. Oh, that's cool. Anyway. Well, yeah. So there's a lot of great riding inside Lake George. I know that. I grew up in Rhode Island, so I went there many times, and it's just so beautiful. A lot of people go there just on vacation. I mean, just to go there.
Yeah. That's one of the things that's great about it is there's thousands and thousands of motel rooms, you know.
Because
it's such a great resort area, you know.
And it's so beautiful. And also the caverns. There's a lot of caves and caverns. And then you rent a boat or go on a boat tour, and they take you inside these caverns up in the Adirondack Mountains. I mean, I never knew that stuff was there until I started going up there, you know, in my teenage years. And
there is no lack of things to see and do around here.
Yeah.
We're a very beautiful ride and short ride basically to Lake Placid here. There's some beautiful country there for you, the Olympic venue.
Sure. Yeah. So
not to mention There's a fabulous restaurant up there. The what is it? The Tale of the Pup. Great lobster restaurant.
That's great. Well, you know, any of you folks out there, keep that in mind in the years ahead, that every June, Americade is going on up in Lake George, New York, and one of the most beautiful places in the United States. And as Fred said, the roads are just incredible. And your whole experience is going to be great. Plus, you have your motorcycle. What more could you want? I mean, it's just beautiful. And then Americade with all the different vendors. And again, this is a very unique motorcycle rally in the fact that there's all different types of motorcycles. Instead of going to either a Goldwing event or going to Sturgis, where it's predominantly Harleys, although that's mixed up a lot lately these years too. But
I like some of the, you know, there's a BMW rally, there's a Goldwing rally. That's nice. They're fun. But what I really like is this, where everybody mixes together.
Yep, there you go. It's the rainbow roll of sushi. I don't know why I just thought about it. when you don't know what to get, you get the order of just a little bit of everything. So as far as vendors and stuff, you have a pretty good spread of vendors. They're doing installations up there, and you got seminars. Obviously,
again, it's not as big as normal. But I didn't do a count, but I would guess there's still, I don't know, 300 to 400 vendors here, something like that.
In That's the past, a good number.
We've been known to have 800-900 plus.
Oh, yeah.
You know.
Yeah.
It's still pretty good. There's quite a bit down there in the way of pinstripers and lighting guys and tons of riding gear, you know, and stuff like that. So it's still pretty good. It took us the other day about 2 hours just to walk through it, you know. So
okay, good.
Yeah.
Oh, that's great. So, you know, if anybody wants information on Americade, you can get in touch. We'll have Fred's contact information anyway, because we're going to talk a little bit about Fred's motorcycle tours in New Zealand, which I was happy and lucky enough to partake in last year. And we have that coming up again. So that's something
after
else.
I beat you over the head about it for 10 years.
You did.
Finally got to drag your ass to New Zealand.
You know, you did. You did. Fred had been trying to get me on this tour probably over 10 years. For a long time. And, you know, I'd always have the excuse that I was busy and it's on my bucket list. And, yeah, I have to tell you, when I went, Fred, there's no question. To date, that is the most beautiful place I've ever ridden a motorcycle. It really is.
I know. Everybody who goes, I don't think I've ever had an unhappy customer. Here at Americade, I've already had like six people come up to me and go, "Oh, man, I don't know if you remember me, but I went on one of your tours. That was the best time of my life," you know?
No, I agree. You know, I'd never been to New Zealand in my life. And when I went last year with Fred and we had a group that we organized together of WingStuff customers, and we ended up doing the South Island and the North Island, I'll tell you what, I knew it was beautiful. I knew a little bit about New Zealand, but I didn't realize what I was missing. I didn't realize how beautiful it was. And I'm not just saying that. When I tell you it's the most beautiful place I've ever ridden, that's a big deal for me to say that, because I've been to not as many places as you, but I've been to a lot of nice places. And that is the most beautiful place that I've been to so far riding a motorcycle, especially the South Island. That was my favorite.
Mine too. Always is. By the way, just last night I was at this comedy show, Lonzo Bowden, and a lady came up to me, and I apologize because I can't remember if she said she was his sister or sister-in-law or something, but anyway, of Buck DeShazza.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, and she said, "Buck can't stop talking about the tour in New Zealand."
Yes. The
greatest time of his life.
Yes.
And I know he's a good friend of yours.
Yes, he is. He's a good friend. He's been a good customer of WingStuff for many years. And, you know, I have something
about you guys go back to grade school together.
Oh, I don't know about that. But, you know, but we've known each other a long time. And, you know, he just picked up a brand new 2021 Gold Wing yesterday. He just picked up another one. Yeah. He has a Can-Am Spider, and he sold his Gold Wing, and then he missed it so much that he just picked up a brand new red one yesterday. It's on his social media. Yeah.
Wow.
So anyway, Buck was one of the people that were on our New Zealand tour last year. But you know, if we were going to tell people, so everybody, we're organizing another New Zealand tour for next year. So Fred, tell them about the New Zealand tour that you're putting together again. Obviously, it was canceled this past year because of the pandemic, but now it's a green light, and the tour that I took is now coming up again for this coming year coming up. So tell them the dates, tell them everything about it, Fred.
Well, okay. It's going to be, and let me check my own notes so I don't say something wrong. March the 14th through the 28th.
Okay.
And that will be the Mountain Kings tour, the same one you went on.
Yeah.
Okay. Which starts in Auckland and ends in Christchurch. Okay. Right. And I'm going to send you a PDF of the flyer with the prices and stuff. And supposedly my webmaster is putting it up on my website, fredrau.com, as we speak, because we just got the go ahead on this. Prices range from $13,000 to $16,000, but that's New Zealand money. People, okay. The way we work it, we do all of our money through New Zealand, which means whatever the exchange rate is at the time you pay, at the moment you pay, that's what you're actually paying. Now, I checked it this morning, and that $13,000 all-inclusive tour is actually $9,100 in American today. Okay.
Right.
But it really it's inclusive. It includes, I just read it off my own flyer, you know.
Yeah.
Excellent accommodations. I think Rick will attest to that.
And the best.
Finest food you're ever going to find. And includes 13 nights accommodation in deluxe hotels, lodges, two farm stays. Remember one farm stay, sorry.
Yeah.
Airport transfers, your dinners, your breakfast, a night in a Maori village where we had the Hangi feast with the Maori tribe.
Yeah.
In Larnac Castle, the inter-island ferry tickets, your motorcycle with unlimited mileage, a luggage van, a guide on a motorcycle, another guide in the maps, itineraries, tour guides. You know, basically, you show up and you pay for your gas, okay?
That's it, yeah.
And if you want lunch along the way, you know, and as Rick knows, I do not lead a nose-to-tail, follow-the-leader, rigid tour. Every night at dinner, you'll be given options, different rides you can take that next day. They all end up at the same place. But if you wanted a nice casual ride down the seacoast, you wanted a real gnarly, twisty road up in the mountains, you wanted to go visit this museum or that game preserve or whatever, we'll have routes and maps for you for all of that. You choose what you want to do that day. You want to go with me? Hey, you're more than welcome. Follow me. But if you want to go off on your own, usually what we end up with is two bikes go off this way and three go off that way. And, you know, and then we all meet up at dinner that night, you know.
Yes.
It's your vacation. I want to keep it loose. I want you to do what you want to do. Have some fun, you know.
Yeah, that was nice about it, the flexibility where people did that. People took their own routes, and then there was a group of people that liked to stick with you, and that was fine, too.
You know, I like having people along, you know.
Yeah.
But there have literally been tours where I got up in the morning and went out to the parking lot, and all the bikes were gone. Well, I'm the tour leader, for God's sake, you know?
Yeah. But
the thing is, after the first couple of days, you start to feel so comfortable with the country. You begin to realize that you can't really get lost, you know, right. Because they're long, thin islands, north to south. We're starting in the north end and the south. So if you see an ocean, turn.
You know? Right. Well, that's true.
And people start to really, and the people are so nice.
They are.
The road is beautiful. And you start to feel comfortable with it, and you just take off. Me and my buddy, or me and my wife, or, you know, two couples, whatever. We just, let's just go. We don't need a tour guide, you know, we'll just go. Yeah. And I love to see that, because that tells me they're really comfortable and they're having a good time. You
know, I like the pace that we had, where, you know, we were making time. We were moving across the islands, but at the same time, every few days you gave us a day off, and we'd be able to stroll around and see it, you know, the town, and do some souvenir shopping.
3 days in Queenstown and then Nelson, and where we time it so that you could go to the farmers markets, you know.
Yeah.
Or you could go. You could go bungee jumping or hang gliding or sailing or go on a boat cruise. You know what? You'll have time for all of that. And some people want to ride those days. A lot of people don't. They want to take it easy for a day, you know?
Yeah.
And even on the days when we're riding, we always make sure to make a nice coffee stop in the morning, you know, and then
we'll start. Yeah.
Lunch, and then we usually make another coffee stop in the afternoon. You know, it's relaxed.
You know, I'm going to put the cover on the book. The best thing that I can describe about this tour, and I'm happy that I was on it, because I can really say this. It was the word experience. It's not just the tour. It was the whole experience. Everything combined was just so enjoyable and amazing. It was like a combination of the beautiful scenery, riding the motorcycles on some of the most beautiful roads I've ever seen, the food, the culture, the change of climate. Like, you know, we were at Mount Cook, as you remember, looking at a glacier, and like a couple hours later, we were in tropical weather looking at a beach, and we could go swimming in the ocean. I mean, that's the diversity that we were seeing. And it was almost like being, I joked about this on our trip, it was like being on a National Geographic tour, you know? Good.
That's what I'm going for. I don't want you to just flash through the countryside, okay?
Right.
Riding is fun, and riding is a big part of it. But I want you to get to know New Zealand also.
Yes, that's what I'm...
The culture and the food. And the
people,
you know? Yeah. And I really try to do that. I think the night in the Mitai Maori village goes a long way toward that. We'd learn about the Maori culture.
Yeah.
And have the hangi feast with them and everything.
Yeah.
And the night in the Larnac castle up on the mountain, you know. And then your farm stay, when you get to meet the local farmers and stay at their house, you know. Gracious people that take you into their home and treat you like family, you know?
Yeah, I mean, you know, everybody in New Zealand, like, you know, the whole vibe of New Zealand, because unless you've been to a country, every country in a place has a vibe. And the vibe was, everybody was so friendly. I mean, so friendly. Yeah. And they loved talking to us. And, you know, the things that I saw and that I experienced, especially when we stayed at the castle on this tour, Fred mentioned we stay at a castle. Well, it's a real castle, and we actually stay there. One thing I can tell you about the tour, everybody, is you stay in some of the best accommodations across these islands. I mean, you know, Fred has you staying at some of the best places. And
remember the little chalets up at Mount Cook?
Yes. Oh, yes. That was so beautiful.
Right on the site of Sir Edmund Hillary's base camp when he was training for Everest. We have these beautiful little Swiss chalets.
Beautiful. I remember that. And the roofs were on such an extreme angle, because I would imagine they get a lot of snow and the weather up there, right? Yeah. So it was kind of like, it wasn't the North Pole, but it was kind of like that experience where it's like, wow, I just came out of 80 degree weather and now I'm next to a glacier and I'm sleeping in this house that's shaped kind of like an iron, you know? And it was just such an experience.
At that same place, remember the buffet?
The food was incredible. I remember we stopped and we stayed at some real old places that had a lot of history. I had some hot chocolate. It was like the best hot chocolate I had in my life. I'm just telling you, some of the food, the drinks, the whole experience, but even the castle. I want to tell you something funny. You know, they were giving us a tour of the castle and they were showing us how they lit the castle. And they used to have people in the basement pedaling these things that look like bicycles. And what it was, it would push the gas through all the tubes to light up all the chandeliers in the castle. And there were people down below while people were in the castle eating and this and that. There were people, servants down there pedaling these things to keep all the lights on. It was pretty incredible. I didn't realize all that. So, and this all comes on a New Zealand motorcycle tour. I'm just saying, I enjoyed everything, you know, except the motorcycle. I mean, the motorcycle part of it was great, but let's push that aside. The tour itself without the motorcycles was worth going. It was just so incredible. I mean, the experience and the places we saw, and then you stick the bike under my butt and send me on these roads that like the most beautiful roads I've ever seen. It was a heck of an experience. And that's why I love promoting this because I'm very proud of it. Yeah. It's something that if anybody goes, I will tell you right now, I will guarantee you it's going to be the ride of a lifetime and an experience in a lifetime. It's not just the riding, and the riding is incredible. It's just the whole experience. So I think you did a good job, Fred, where you've mixed it up. You've made yourself unique because not only do you have a tour, but you've done the tour so that, you know, the food's the best. The places that you take people that we stayed were the best. And the experiences that we had at those places were very unique. And, you know, it was just the whole thing. I know that when we all came home, we all just couldn't stop talking about how great an experience it was. That's why that's the key word. It's the whole experience. It was a lifetime experience. And if any of you out there get a chance to join Fred on this ride, and I'm going to try to make it again this year as well, you will not be sorry.
I would love it, Rick. We had so much fun.
I know. I would love it. Well, you can hear it in my voice that I'm excited to talk about it.
I don't have to talk you into it anymore.
Oh no, it was unbelievable. And just, I mean, the roads were just so beautiful. So beautiful. And nature, hopefully they don't build too many things in New Zealand too quickly, because I'll tell you, it's almost like, you know, nature is preserved there. It's just such a special place. And I hope we don't screw it up. I hope in 20 years I don't, you know, there's it's just not lined with buildings and cities, and because it's just so beautiful. What a gem. What a gem in this world New Zealand really is.
Yeah. So. Okay. You've gushed over my tour enough. Thank you.
I know. And, you know, we're going to have all the information on our website for Fred.
Yeah.
I know. And you know, so Fred's website's going to have all the info, but we're going to have all the info on wingstuff.com with this podcast. So we'll give your contact information and everything else. And if people are interested, they can get in touch with you. They can get the information. And I would encourage everybody to really think about taking time out and going for a trip of a lifetime.
I make one tiny little disclaimer right here that I am going to be on the road for the next three weeks. So if you email me and you don't get a response right away, I'm not ignoring you, but I will get back to you. But I may not. It may not be immediately. It might be a day or two. Okay.
We should be good. Yeah, we should be good. It's going to take us just a few days to edit this and get this out there live anyway. So, I'm excited. So we heard a lot about Americade. We learned all about this tour in New Zealand. And for additional information, I encourage all you people to get in touch with Fred, and he'll give you all the info you need. And as far as the tour goes, you don't need anything. All you need to do is show up. And
well,
they have everything.
Riding gear, you know.
Oh, yeah. Well, obviously, bring your riding gear with you. And so that's about it. Other than that, what else is going on, Fred? Nothing else? That's about it, right?
No, not really. I've been filling in the time. I've actually been working as a vaccine courier for the emergency management department. To keep the wolf from the door, since I haven't had any tour money coming in for almost 2 years. Other than that, you know, everything's okay.
That's good.
We're surviving. We're hanging in there.
That's great.
Just let me get these tours up and running again, and all will be good.
There you go. All right. Perfect. Well, I'm going to let you get back to your time at Americade, and thanks for carving out some time to do this podcast with us this morning.
Always glad to hear and talk to you, Rick. What do we go back 30 years, 40 years?
Go back a long time, Fred. Yes, we do.
I was a managing editor at a magazine, and you were a parts counter manager at a Honda dealership.
Yes. Yep.
When we first met, and that's going back a ways, boy. I think that was about 1990.
Yeah, it's about right.
So that'd be 31 years ago, man.
Good memory. That's right, Fred.
Turning into old farts.
Yeah, there you go. Good friendship, too.
Good one always, Rick. Good to see you.
Well, listen, enjoy Americade. Say hi to your wife for me.
Absolutely.
And I look forward to seeing you when you get home. Fred and I kind of live near each other. We're within about 45 minutes.
Apart. Yeah.
Yeah. Not too far apart. So I'll see you when you get back.
Yeah, I just bought myself a BMW. We'll take a little ride up in the hills, man.
Sounds good. Yeah. All right. Well, with that, I want to thank all our listeners for listening this morning to the program. And stay safe. And Fred, just have nothing but fun out there. And I look forward to seeing you when you get back.
All right. See you, Rick.
All right. Take care. Thanks, everybody. Ride safe.
Well, I feel like checking on Uncle Frank. We'll see how he's doing. And we'll have a little hey with Uncle Frank now. So let's give him a quick call.
Hello. Hey, Uncle Frank. How are you?
Hi. What's up with you?
I got you on the podcast series again on the live radio show. I just want to say hi to you, and everybody wants to hear you say hi to them.
Yeah. Okay. Let me know when. When do I say it?
You can say it now. They're all listening to you. How you doing? Tell them how you doing today.
I'm doing good.
How you doing?
I'm doing very good today.
Yeah.
I hope it's like that every day.
Good. Yeah. Of course. I hear the television in the background going.
Yeah. It's got the TV on. That's all I do all day. Just watch television. That's all I do.
Yeah.
There's nothing else to do. What am I going to do?
But you enjoy the TV, right? You enjoy it.
Yeah, of course.
All right.
The only thing left to do, what is there? I ain't got nothing else to do.
Well, you know, I try to get you out to play some bingo or something. We have to take you, maybe do something like that. You know, you might be the big winner.
Yeah, that's a good thing, but it never happens.
All right. Next time I come, I'm going to take you to the casino. We're going to try to play some bingo, see if we can make some money.
Yeah, we're going to try. I hope so.
All right.
Well, I haven't been there for quite a while, so.
Yeah, that's in Connecticut. We'll go to Connecticut.
Yeah, who's it? This Rick?
Of course it's Rick. Who do you think it is?
Oh, I don't know. I thought you had me on a speakerphone.
I have you on a podcast on a live radio show right now. You're talking. You're saying hi to everybody. You're letting them walk.
Oh, okay. I didn't know that. I forgot.
Yeah. How old are you, Uncle Frank? Tell him again. We got to remind everybody.
92.
92 years old, young. There you go.
Yeah, young, all right. I wish I was young.
Don't mess with Uncle Frank, because I'll tell you what, you're going to lose.
Yeah, right.
There you go.
I'm still pretty good, though, for a 92-year-old. I mean,
yes,
what am I going to do?
Yes, you are.
We're going to eat now.
What are you going to eat tonight, Uncle Frank?
Did he make fish patties, the patties, with
the
cheese on top.
Did he make them or did he buy them made?
No, he bought that fish and they're cooking them, it's all, putting the cheese on it, and that's it.
Okay, good. All right. Well, that sounds good. So, all right, you're going to enjoy your dinner, and then I'll call you later. And, you know, say goodbye to everybody.
Okay, goodbye, you guys. I hope you have a good day every time.
There you go. All right, that's Uncle Frank there. And Uncle Frank, give him one of your, hey!
Hey, you guys, what are you doing?
All right, good. All right, sounds good, Uncle Frank. All right, take care. Enjoy your dinner, and I'll talk to you later.
Okay? All right, right. Bye-bye.
Love you.
Bye.
Bye.
Love you.
Bye.
Thanks for listening to WingCast. This has been a WingStuff.com production. Please be sure to rate, review, and subscribe to us wherever you listen to podcasts. Got a question or comment for me? Send an email to WingCast@WingStuff.com, and it could be featured on a future episode. You can also visit WingStuff.com and sign up for our newsletter to stay up to date on the newest podcast episodes, products, videos, Goldwing news, sales, and more. Until next time, I'm Rick Arnoldo. Ride safe.